Damascus Road was a tough road, period. But he's on his way there, and he says to himself, I've got to stop these people who are changing the land, and I've got to do it with what I have to work with. He's gone to his superiors. He says to himself, I'm going to be about the business of changing this society and making sure it never changes from what it is. But while he's on his way, something happens. He has what you need to have tonight in order to make unhappy new you. He has a God encounter. Listen, I said he has an encounter with God. I want you to understand tonight that nothing is going to really change significantly in your life until you have an encounter with God. Well, listen, are you looking at somebody? I want to just tell the folks here tonight who don't know me very well that, listen, I pastored a church for 30-some years, and while I was pastoring, I was drinking, I was smoking, I was gambling. Come on. Listen, after service like this tonight, I'd be on my way out to a little spot on the west end of Richmond where everybody was white. Nobody knew me. RJ, nobody knew me. I sit up in my little corner in the dark, amen, with my cognac and my Newports and whole court with my boys and say, man, how was staying tonight with you? How you been doing, man? Smoking my Newport, drinking my yak, and I drank yak until it was gone.
Yeah.
My God.
Yeah.
Come on.
One day, I asked myself a question, the same as Jack Nicholson asked on his way out of the shrink's office. Is this as good as it gets?
Wow.
Is this all life is? Because the world parties like this. I mean, this what they do. You mean to tell me I don't know any different than what they know? There's no different than their lifestyle than mine. The only difference is mine's in secret and theirs is in the open.
Yeah.
This is as good as it gets. And I said, God, I don't want to live like this anymore. I want something different. And he said something to me. There are three ways this can happen to you. The first way that the Bible says that people try to do it is that it can be bought. But touch your neighbor and say, it can't be bought. It
can't be bought.
People think they can buy it. They can buy a relate an encounter with God. In Acts chapter 8, Simon tried Diane to buy an encounter with God. He gave his money. He said, listen, let me just, hey, I want some of that. Whatever it is, y'all got that Holy Ghost stuff that Elder Tavares was talking about, that Holy Spirit stuff, that holy stuff. Listen, it looked like it's working pretty good. I want some of that. And they really said to Simon, as he gave his money, said, dude, take your money and go back to 7734. Okay, turn it upside down. You figure it out on your way home. Go back. Go back there, because you don't belong with us. You're trying to buy your way into the kingdom of God, and it can't be bought. Come on. I've had people to tell me all over and over again, Rev, you on your way to church? Yeah, I'm on my way to church. Here, put this in the bucket. $200, you know. Drop this in the bucket. Get $500. Drop $1,000. Put this in. You're going to church. Just want God to know I appreciate him.
Wow.
It's okay. But you really want God to appreciate, know that you appreciate him? You ought to go take it yourself. Because you can't buy your way. I've seen them. Rich folks have a boy in Chicago, a pimp in Chicago, got his picture in the Jet magazine one year. And he was laying in his casket, amen. It was a Mercedes casket or something like that. He was laying in the casket and he had $100 bills hanging out of his hand. And he was looking cool. I was saying to myself, somebody ought to get them $100 bills. Somebody. He can't take away either one. Come on, to get them diamonds off his hand. Get them $100 bills out of his hand. He can't charge it. He can't take them where he's going. Somebody ought to get that money and those diamonds. Sell them, give them to somebody. Something ought to be done. don't know how much he paid the pastor for preaching. And people have come to my office many times and said, Bishop, you know, my uncle or my father or my brother died, and you know, he wasn't a bad guy. And I'm sitting there saying to myself, they're trying to give me this story to try to figure out, am I going to preach him into heaven? And I look at him and say, I can't do it. Well, we got a lot of money, and we're gonna take care of you after the service today. Praise God, whatever you do, but you keep that money if you think I'm going to tell everybody he went to heaven, because it ain't my heaven to put him in.
That's right. That's right.
An encounter with God cannot be fought. There is a second portion of it, though. It can be sought.
Mm. Yeah.
That in Acts chapter 2, the disciples had become apostles. They had their own God encounter, and they go now, and they're standing. He says, go to the upper room, stay there until the Holy Spirit comes. And he says, whatever he wants to do, he's to go pray. Worship. And as they were seeking the Lord, something happened. Acts chapter 13, the same thing happens. While they were seeking the Lord, worshiping, praying, listen, something happens, and the Lord, he sets apart Barnabas and Saul and says, go and do my work. Because he knows, listen, Psalm 100 verse 4 says what? It says, enter into his gates with what? Thanksgiving, into his courts with praise. There's something that happens when we seek the Lord. The joy of the Lord is our strength. That's what we ought to do, seek our parents right there. That was a good illustration. I was just waiting for it to happen. Seeking is something you ought to be doing tonight if you want an encounter with God. Even now, while you're still sitting there, I dare somebody right where you are to just declare right now, Father, I want you. God, I
Brother,
want
I you.
I came tonight because I was looking for something different. God, I came early tonight. I had plans to go out after tonight. And God, listen, even if I get to the place where I was going, I know that I'm here for a reason. And I got in this place, amen. I got in this place for a reason. And I'm looking for an encounter with you tonight. Somebody declare that right where you are. I'm looking for an encounter with you tonight, God. Some strings. I want some strings.